Good morning. Thank you for your kind introduction. I'd like to take this opportunity to express my gratitude for allowing me to make this presentation. In my presentation, I'd like to introduce Japan's experience by focusing on measures and approaches taken by the Japan Patent Office. My presentation consists of three parts. First, I will talk about recent development of the economic relationship between India and Japan. Next, I will talk about the innovation policy and IP policy in Japan. Lastly, I will talk about international collaboration activities taken by the Japan Patent Office for promoting innovation. And now, let me explain the recent development of the economic relationship between India and Japan. Yesterday morning sessions, I gave some sort of outline of the relationship between the two countries. But in this presentation, I will give you some sort of concrete pictures. Please take a look at the right chart on the upper left-hand side. This chart shows the changes in number of Japanese residents and Japanese companies resided in India. As you can see from this chart, the number of both Japanese residents and Japanese companies in India are steadily increasing. Now please look at the bar graph on the upper right hand side. This graph shows the changing in export and import value between India and Japan. As indicated by this graph, export and import value between the two countries have increased in recent years. Please look at the bar graph on the bottom. This graph shows the changes in amount of direct investment made by Japan in BRICS countries. As indicated by the blue bar, that represents investments in India. The amount of Japanese direct investment in India has increased in recent years. Next, I'd like to explain the situation of patent application filed by India, filed in India by Japanese applicants. The bar graph on the left shows the changes in number of patent applications filed in India by Japanese applicants. The graph shows that the number of patent applications filed from Japan to India increased along with the deepening of economic relationship between India and Japan. The pie chart on the right shows the breakdown of patent applications filed in India by nation, nationality of applications. The top chart is for the year 2002 and the bottom for the year 2010. These charts indicate that the percentage of patent applications filed in India by Japanese applicants increased from 3% in 2002 to 10% in 2010. Now, I'd like to talk about the Japan-India Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. The CEPA, which was signed by the two countries in 2011 in a Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, that covers cooperation in a wide range of areas, including investment, intellectual property, government prosecution, competition, and improvement of the business environment. Next, I will explain the innovation and IP policy in Japan. Now, let me briefly explain the 127-year history of the IPR system in Japan using the chronological table. In the earliest years after the establishment of the patent system in 1885 in Japan, the system was used mainly by independent inventors. As a result of business expansion by independent inventors who has utilized intellectual property, many businesses emerged contributing to industrial modernization. Sakichi Toyoda, who is the founder of the Toyota Motor Company, is included in a great Japanese inventors. Furthermore, during the post-war reconstruction period, Japan's rapid economic growth was supported by utilizing foreign patents through international technology transfer. As a result of economic globalization, intellectual property is now being utilized as a mechanism to create innovation and achieve an IP-based nation. Now, let me analyze the economic growth and its effects of Japan in recent years. On the graph at the left, the blue line shows GDP, and the red one, the number of patent applications. As you can see, there is a very close positive correlation between GDP and the number of patent applications. In Japan, innovation has been accelerated along with economic growth, and the number of patent applications has also increased. What are the causes then? Please look at the graph on the right side. The graph shows comparison between R&D expenditure of each country and the number of patent applications of each country. The comparison indicated that a large amount of money has been spent to cover R&D activities in Japan while filing a large number of patent applications. In other words, Japan has been utilizing R&D results as a driving force of the economic growth. In recent years, the Japanese government has been setting a national strategy for making Japan an IP-based nation in order to further accelerate innovations. In 2003, the Japanese government established an IP strategy headquarters, which was headed by the Prime Minister. By the IP strategy headquarters, an intellectual property strategic program is formulated each year. Japan's government ministries and agencies, including the JPO, implement various measures in line with the IP strategic program of each year. Aiming at the arising of an IP-based nation, the JPO has been making various efforts as a key player in terms of promoting innovations. However, there are also new challenges. In these modern days of rapid globalization, existing business models have begun to be rather useless. Only with outstanding technology, for example, it is difficult to survive the patent global competition, present global competition. Similarly, only with a good design or brand, you cannot easily be accepted. Changes in the innovation cycle are now taking place. Conventional invention cycle is shown in a blue, which is the technology-driven cycle that starts from creation of technology to protection of rights and utilization. The orange-colored cycle is the present business-driven cycle. The need to newly utilize this cycle has increased. This is cycle to develop the IP resources based on business. A comprehensive IP management united with business and strategic IP utilization has become extremely important. Let me talk about Toyota Motor Company as an example of success story by utilizing IPR. Toyota is one of the most successful companies founded by the independent inventor. The founder, Sakichi Toyoda, decided to dedicate himself to create inventions. He finally developed the non-stop automatic loom. Afterwards, he assigned the automatic loom patent to a British company. Then, by utilizing the money of $10 million at current price, received from assigning the loom patent, his son started developing cars. In this way, Toyota Motor Company cars are in existence. Furthermore, as you may well know, Toyota has become a leading brand in the world in terms of strong user support based on reliability. This is a perfect example of how intellectual property and especially the patent system can be a powerful driving force to develop and advance business and the economy. Next, I'd like to introduce another leading company founded driving during the period of initial industrial development. This next case is about Panasonic, which was formerly called Matsushita Electronics. It was founded by Konosuke Matsushita. He started his business with his wife and younger brother-in-law by making wiring equipment. He accurately sensed the need by consumers for better and better products. As a result, he developed a two-way socket, like the one shown in the picture, that did indicate, indeed respond to consumer needs. Panasonic, which has now grown into the leading company in the world, while the largest number of international applications in the world, its capital is now $3 billion, with annual sales of $110 billion. This case is a perfect example demonstrating the success divided from apparently sensing consumer needs, which is resulted in inventions. It is possible to achieve great success based on simple, continuously improving inventions, which themselves are not necessary great breakthroughs. Lastly, I will talk about the international collaboration on the JPO by promoting innovation. First, I'll explain the background surrounding intellectual property in the world. These bar graphs show the changes in number of patent applications filed in the world and the changes in number of patent applications filed by Japanese applicants. At the time when the number of patent filings in the world are increasing, the rate of increase for foreign filings is higher than that for national filings. The reason is that with the globalization of economic activities, applicants are filing applications for the same subject matter to IP offices in more than one country. This is also the same with Japanese applicants. The percentage of foreign patent filings by Japanese applicants has almost doubled from 17% to 36% from the year 2010. In order to respond to the changes surrounding intellectual property, I talked about at the beginning of my presentation, the JPO has formulated the strategy shown on this front. First of all, a means of resolving the issue of prolonged duration of examination procedures is a patent prosecution highway shown at the right hand side. This is a framework of utilizing examination results of another IP office for the purpose of providing results of patent examination to applicants in a short period of time. Furthermore, what becomes apparent from mutual utilization examination results through the PPH and PCT was the difference of examination results between the IP offices. The reason for this, we feel, is different system and practice of each country. In order to solve such a problem, harmonization patent system is necessary. JPO would like to contribute continuously the progress of harmonization of world patent system. It is necessary to develop the IP environment in order to expand its trade and investment as well as promote further innovations. That is to say, when the requirements such as making procedures more user-friendly and properly protecting intellectual property are met, innovators are able to conduct international businesses in countries other than their own countries without any worries. At present, 146 countries have joined the ECP. On the other hand, the number of countries which accede the Hague agreement related to design or the Madrid protocol related to trademark is not enough yet. The AFTA anti-counterfeiting trade agreement provides a higher level protection for trademarks than before. At present, many countries regions, including Mexico, Japan, and the U.S., accede the agreement. When India accedes to these agreements, it would make it easier for both Japanese and Indian companies to do business. These improvements to the IP environment will encourage innovation throughout the world and become the driving force behind economic development. Thank you very much for your kind attention.